1-250. If he wins the World Championship when he was 51 points behind, it would be the biggest comeback since the start of the premier class of Grand Prix racing. And he's got a few fans here, hasn't he?
Oh, there's a bit of momentum there in the seas of yellow spotted around the circuit in the stands. And, yeah, Valentino, that is a massive comeback. And this was Nicky Hayden. He only made 42 points since he won at Laguna against Rossi's 101 points and just evaporated that points lead he had. And now the pressure's on Nicky. He's all plugged in there, getting fired up for the 30 lapper. And out there on the grid, this is the nervous wait. This is a, well, it's kind of a little bit of a pain in the backside, you'd have to say, Nick, or the boys just want to get off and get racing. But this is part of the process that's got to be done. And they're sitting there, and after this, they head out on the warm-up lap, come back, grid up, and then they're off. But yeah, this is the longest 5 or 10 minutes in Nicky Hayden's life, without a doubt.
Well, I've got the man on the back with me at the moment, Nicky Hayden. This is it, as your leathers say, it's all in.
Yeah, that's what it all comes down to right here. And, you know, it's an awesome opportunity, man. Full house, not a seat in the house, 130,000 fans, and a shot at the title. So, like I said all along this weekend, I got to go all in, go for the win. And, you know, I feel really good. I'm really excited, and sure, there's a lot on the line. But for me, I can just go try to win this race, see what happens.
All right, leave you to it. Thanks, Nicky.
All right, thanks, brother.
Nicky Hayden. He's qualified fifth fastest. He starts from the second row of the grid. And he has to beat this man, Valentino Rossi. Rossi's got two wins here in Valencia. Not his favourite circuit, but he has looked very, very good indeed in qualifying and practice. Decimated the lap record in qualifying yesterday to take pole position. And alongside him on that front row of the grid, as we said, Troy Bayliss. What a performance him by him, the 2006 World Superbike Champion. Well, a one-off ride for Troy Bayliss.
One-off ride for Troy Bayliss, but it's the last ride for Casey Stoner on the LCR team. End of a long partnership, but you still must be excited. Good warm-up for you this morning, except for that little whoopsie fastest.
Yeah, I mean, everything seemed to be working pretty well this morning. We just had an unfortunate little slide in the front, but other than that, you know, we're reasonably confident with the setup. We've gambled a little bit with the front tyre, but we'll just see how it works.
Well, all the best, mate. We'll leave you to it. You got that race face on already.
Thank you.
Casey Stoner has qualified seventh fastest. He was fastest in the morning warm-up. His last ride for LCR Honda. He won't be replacing this man. That's a bit unfair, really, because Troy Bayliss isn't going to ride the bike once, but he will be riding Troy. He will be in Troy Bayliss's place in the Ducati team, but, of course, riding an 800cc machine.
Now, I've got another Australian with me right beside Casey Stoner on the grid, Chris Vermeulen on the Rizla Suzuki. It's not your last ride for the Rizla Suzuki, but the last ride for the year. But pretty good here. You know the track.
Yeah, it's been a lot easier knowing the circuit. You know, I came here on Superbike a lot and never won around here, but had a lot of success, you know, finishing second two times last year. And the Suzuki's working well so far. The Bridgestone tyres are pretty good. It's a lot hotter today, you know, and we've got to see how everything goes, you know, for 30 laps.
That's what I was going to ask. A lot hotter in the temperature and the tyre. Always a gamble at the best of times, but when the conditions are so different.
It is, you know, and it's knowing what the tyre's going to do when, and it's the same boat for everyone, you know. Nobody's tested in this temperature, and we just got to take a gamble.
All right, all the best, Chris.
Thanks, Braxton.
Chris Vermeulen has qualified eighth fastest on the Rizla Suzuki. What a season he's had, his debut season in MotoGP. Shinya Nakano, we looked at him earlier, didn't we? His last ride for Kawasaki. He won the 250cc race here back in the year 2000. He is a super rider, and perhaps a change talking of team is what he may need. Sorry, Mark.
Talking of super riders, I've got Troy Bayliss second on the grid. You come here for a bit of fun. It doesn't get much more than fun than being on the front row, Troy.
No, it's really nice to be on the front row, but, you know, it's going to be a very difficult race today. I'll just go out there and try and do my race and see how it unfolds, but it's been a perfect weekend so far.
Now, a lot of hotter temperatures. Just talking to Chris Vermeulen. Did you settle on a tyre this morning? Good warm-up for you as well?
Yeah, no, the warm-up for me was so-so, but honestly, the tyre that we picked should work better for this sort of condition.
All right, we'll leave you to it. Thanks, Troy.
Cheers, mate. Take care.
What a performance by Troy Bayliss. Second fastest, the World Superbike champion. His one-off ride for Ducati and MotoGP. But Nicky Hayden, I think you're right. Just wants to get underway now, doesn't he?
He's just got to win it. That's all he can do. And then the rest has to take care of itself. If Rossi has any kind of issues or just can't cut the pace and does finish in third place or worse, and Nicky can win, as I say, that's all Hayden can do. He has to win it, and just the more the more points he takes by the win, obviously the 25, then the higher Rossi's got to finish up the field. And that's a pretty weird thing to say about Valentino Rossi, world champion for the last five consecutive years, and then alternate years before that, the 250, and then 2 years before that, the 125 championship.
I've got Valentino Rossi's not too keen on talking today, but his teammate Colin Edwards is talking. You've not had the best one. Friday wasn't the best for you, but you found something secret this morning.
Yeah, we're going all right. You know what I mean? We're in a pretty bad starting position to help the teammate out, but we're going to do what we can the first few laps and see if we can get through these guys.
Yeah, well, that's the thing. Getting through these guys is a very hard place to pass.
It is that. You know, it's not going to be easy, and it's pretty easy to get trapped behind somebody, you know, if they're faster in one section than you are. So just have to be careful and be aggressive the first few laps.
We'll get that tornado flying, mate.
You got it. Thanks.
Colin Edwards has qualified 10th fastest, also announced at the weekend that he has re-signed for Yamaha. He will be with Valentino Rossi next season. This is Casey Stoner, we've already spoken to. Good start for Nicky Hayden, Kevin. It's not crucial, it's just
essential.
Yeah, absolutely essential.
Yeah, starting out of the middle of the second row in fifth position, Nicky Hayden. Stoner there out of seventh, so starting off the third row. Said in that interview there with Braxy, he took a bit of a gamble on the front tyre, and they'll be hoping that'll pay off.
Now I'll move down the back of the grid to Gary McCoy, second race for the Ilmor. A bit of chattering problems during the first couple of days. How have you been going in the qualifying and the warm-up?
Yeah, we're still struggling to find it, really, but you know, it's the first time we've turned a wheel here at this track, and we've just had the 2 hours per day, and now here we are at the race, and you know, we're going into the race with a few problems. We're just going to try and ride around them and do the best we can.
Yeah, well, that's the thing. You've 20% down on capacity, and I'll say about the 20% down on top speed as well. You're pretty good in the first couple of sections, but this long straight really shows the difference.
Yeah, it does. You know, during practice and even qualifying, the guys seem to pass me pretty easy down the straights, and you know, that really hurts us a lot, and you know, for sure in a lap. And also some of the, like the back straights and the little straights in between, they really seem to have a lot more bottom end than what we do.
Well, it's good to see you back on a GP grid anyway, Gary.
Thank you.
Gary McCoy, it's qualified 20th fastest on that 800cc Ilmor. This is Chris Vermeulen. He qualified 8th. Alongside him would be his teammate, John Hopkins. Both of them are on Bridgestone tyres. We have the Bridgestone tyre choice that's just been delivered to us. Kevin, what have we got?
We have got basically everybody on the medium rears from Bayless, Caparossi on the Ducatis, Dipunier, Nakano on the Kawasaki's, Hopkins, Vermeulen. So all the same rears, the medium rears. As far as the fronts go, Bayless and Caparossi on the Ducatis have gone medium. Hopkins and Vermeulen on the Suzuki's have gone mediums on the front as well. So it's mediums front and rear for those. The only difference being that Randy Dipunier and Shinya Nakano have whacked in the hard front slicks. So everything's medium except for Dipunier and Nakano's fronts. They've gone to the hard side of things to try and get through the 30 lapper. A lot of hard braking and hard work on the front end around this circuit, Nick, here at Valencia, especially the last turn over the crest and down the hill, leaned over still very hard on the brakes. Hopkins just getting ready for takeoff.
Qualified 9th fastest, John Hopkins. This is Randy Dipunier. He's qualified 11th fastest, Randy Dipunier. Another former 250cc winner here. Caught us all a little bit by surprise on Friday afternoon, led the way for a little while, and I think probably it slipped in a couple of qualifying tyres. It's been a difficult first year for him in the MotoGP class.
It has been, and with the goalposts being moved, if you like, with the 990s going down to 800s, Kawasaki, you've just sort of got to reinvent things a bit, but the amount of information they would have learnt from the last few years with the 990 would be obviously invaluable to the development of the 800. You can see there the pace car heads off, safety car heads off, BMW safety car, and 5 minutes to go before the start of this one.
5 minutes to go before the start of the final showdown. You're at the Ricardo Tormo circuit at Valencia in Spain. You're with us. You're with about 129,999 other people. They await for the start of this absolutely crucial showdown. Marco Melandri, he's currently a third in the championship, but he's not had a good qualifying session. Marco Melandri, he's 12th fastest. again in Portugal, didn't have the best of times. He's third in the championship, 8 points in front of Loris Caparossi. So it's an important race for him. But it almost seems like since he re-signed for the Gresini Honda team, things haven't gone quite his way.
Yeah, he's sort of planning on getting it all right next year and being, you know, a frontline championship contender. But he did win here last year, so he's got a good experience here. But he just wasn't getting the knuckle punching right there.
Tony Elias, what a ride by him just 2 weeks ago. Came from nowhere to win the Grand Prix of Portugal. Of course, teammate to Marco Melandri. He's qualified 13th fastest. He'd be disappointed with that, but we just don't know what's going to come, do we, after the way he rode in Portugal?
No, exactly, and they can come through from behind quite quickly, and signed up also with Melandri, so that team remains the same, the Fortuna team, for next season in 2007. Like Kenny Roberts at Portugal, came from pretty much nowhere and was threatening for the win.
Here we go, the front row of the grid for the final showdown. Loris Caparossi, Troy Bayliss, and the world champion and the championship leader, Valentino Rossi. Let battle commence. Wow. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. We've been waiting 2 weeks for this day, for this moment, this hour. 30 laps, just over 4 kilometres the circuit, just under 2.5 miles. Look at that front row. Troy Bayliss, Loris Caparossi, and the champion and the championship leader, Valentino Rossi. Second row, Shinya Nakano, Danny Pedrosa in the middle. The championship contender, Nicky Hayden, who led the way for so long. Third row, Casey Stoner, fastest in the morning warm-up. The two Suzukis, Chris Vermeulen and John Hopkins. Fourth row, Colin Edwards. What a great job he did for Valentino Rossi in Portugal. Randy Depunier and the man who won here last year, Marco Melandri. Row five, Tony Elias. Great ride by him 2 weeks ago. He won in Portugal. Kenny Roberts was third and Makoto Tamada. Row six, Carlos Checa, Alex Hoffman and Cardoso. And row seven, all on his own, but putting in some great performances. Well, he's there with James Ellison, the Australian, Gary McCoy. Gentlemen, start your engines.
Gary McCoy won back here in 2000, so he was on the Red Bull Yamaha in those days, and it was a brilliant, bouncy, skatey ride by Gary. But on the 800 Ilmor, we'll see what he can do, but it's more or less a public test for that team, getting ready for the next season, as is the Doctor, getting ready for this 30 laps. Probably this 30 laps would be the most important 30 laps in his career so far.
And that really is saying something, isn't it? A man that's won 7 world titles. I think you're right. And he is just relishing the challenge, isn't he?
Oh, yeah. He loves the fight, especially a dogfight, Valentino. And tight, twisty circuit. And he loves slamming the thing around in these kind of situations, as hard a work as it is. But he just loves it.
There we go. That's the situation. Valentino Rossi leads the championship by 8 points from Nicky Hayden. Yeah, Marco Melandri and Loris Caparossi are going to contest third place. All eyes of the world now are focused on the Italian and the American. Mark Brax, I think it's pretty tense down there.
It certainly is. All the team members here ready with the starters and everything. Looks pretty calm, but I can honestly say that everyone is pretty nervous. First, last race of the year, 17 races in, got basically a cloudless blue sky, 130,000 in its stadium-style racetrack, one of the best viewing, probably the best viewing area in the world if you want to see a Grand Prix. But the nerves, I've got the nerves down as they go around the back of the track. It'll just be interesting to see how and if they can get through that first corner without any major dramas.
Well, I think as everybody has said, Kevin, little did we realise we were in a race, 7 months ago. That first Grand Prix, Valentino Rossi got knocked off on the first bend by Tony Elias. Everything was going on. Loris Caparossi won the race. Little did we think it would come to this, did we?
Your words are still ringing in my ears, Nick, when you said those 2 points that Valentino are going to get could be the deciding part. And you could be a bit of a prophet and you don't know it.
But that's what a world champion is made of. That's the stock he's made of, isn't it, Kevin?
Well, I remember the vision we got there when he got jumped up on his feet in that first corner incident at Jerez at the first round, the start of the season, and He was a bit bemused, and he looked down the track and saw the boys disappearing around into the second corner, and then it was like the penny dropped, and he's bang, over, picks up the bike, gets out of there, ended up 14th and 2 points, as you say, may make the difference in the championship.
The red flag is being shown. The front row of the grid forms up. 17 rounds of the World Championship, making up the 2006 World Championship title. It's the Doctor in pole position. Alongside him, the two booming Ducatis, Troy Bayliss and Loris Caparossi. Behind Troy Bayliss, he's qualified fifth fastest. It's the American, Nicky Hayden. The final showdown, ladies and gentlemen, is about to start. They're underway, and it looks like a very good start by Troy Bayliss from the middle of that front row of the grid.
Rossi looked like he bogged it a bit off the line. He's back in the field there a bit. Bayliss looks like he leads him into turn one, followed by Caparossi. Maybe Danny Pedrosa in third, I think.
Certainly it's the two Ducatis there. Bayliss leads the way. Valentino Rossi, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, sixth place. We look for Nicky Hayden. There's certainly a Repsol Honda there.
Just in front of Pedrosa. Just in front of Rossi, I think maybe Nick is one of the Repsols, whether it's Hayden or Pedrosa, can't quite tell.
There we go, it's Hayden in fifth place, Rossi in sixth place. That's quite a good start there for Nicky Hayden, that's where he wanted to be. But Troy Bayliss is making the pace at the front. Loris Caparossi in second place. Casey Stoner, we know, will make a good start. Casey Stoner has made a good start, but this is the start of a man really in form. Troy Bayliss, the World Superbike champion, leads the way at the MotoGP finale. Fantastic start by the Australian.
Pedrosa through the second.
Danny Pedrosa now up into second place. So he's gonna try and help Nicky Hayden. Hayden is in front of Rossi at the moment. As far as the championship goes, this is exactly how we would have wanted it, as Bayliss leads the way. Pedrosa up into second place. Loris Caparossi has been relegated to third place. In fourth place, Nicky Hayden, Casey Stoner, 5, Marco Melandri, 6, Valentino Rossi is down in seventh place. Wow, if it remained the same, the championship would be absolutely on a knife edge.
Exactly, and we're right there now, so this is nearly the end of the first lap. Bayliss leads him out over the line, Pedrosa, and Caparossi looking for a way around Danny Pedrosa. Looks like Nicky Hayden looking for a way past Caparossi, not going to do it this time.
Rossi 1.7 seconds off the lead. Hayden 0.9 of a second off the lead.
Let's look at the start again. Fantastic start by Troy Bayliss. Valentino Rossi really bogged it, didn't he, Kevin?
Yeah, he just didn't get the jump right. And that's looks like Nicky Hayden right beside him. So they're just about rubbing elbows.
They were.
And there you go. That's what it's like. And that's down into the first turn off the line. And Okabe there looking on, but still Bayliss leads him. Got a bit of a gap to Pedrosa. Hayden up the inside of Caparossi.
Hayden now up into third place. This is good for Nicky Hayden. Valentino Rossi, we know, will fight back. Bayliss leads, Pedrosa second, Hayden third. It's for Loris Caparossi in fourth. Casey Stoner in fifth. And there is Valentino Rossi. Just get a glimpse of that yellow helmet. He's not where he wants to be as it stands at the moment. So it's Melandri and Stoner in front of Rossi, but it's still Bayliss leading the way, upping the pace. Now Pedrosa sets after him. Nicky Hayden behind Pedrosa. This is good news for those two. There we are, Caparossi, Melandri, Stoner now coming under increasing pressure.
And Melandri moved past Caparossi there to steal another position. So Marco Melandri absolutely on a mission, come from nowhere, yeah, really.
Pedrosa going to get the board, Hayden P0, so they let him know that he's right behind him.
Well done, Mark. That's exactly what we want to know. Danny Pedrosa hasn't got to do anything at the moment but try and catch Bayliss at the front, has he? Here is Nicky Hayden, right behind Danny Pedrosa. Thinks about coming outside the slipstream. There's Valentino Rossi, tucked in behind Casey Stoner. There's absolutely nothing he can do at the moment. Rossi is in seventh place. Nicky Hayden is in third place. And Nicky Hayden, you would imagine, takes over second place. Hayden moves into second place.
And a good move by Pedrosa, moving right outside to let him in by the look of it. He didn't overcook that on purpose.
Whoa, this isn't over by any means now, is it? This is a fantastic start for the Repsol Honda team.
This is the exact recipe we can do. You can see there Nicky Hayden just dumping it right up the inside, and Danny Pedrosa looking just a fraction lane there and letting his teammate through. And here comes Marco Melandri. A lot of good boys on the pace, and plenty of positions between Nicky Hayden and Valentino Rossi at the moment, including Casey Stoner there on screen.
Rossi's not happy back there, is he? There's no doubt about it. He bogged off the line. He's not getting away from Chris Vermeulen or Shinya Nakano. He does ride better when the Yamaha lightens up with the fuel load, but he's not happy to be that far back now. Danny Pedrosa, will he slow the pace and try to let Hayden get away?
Well, he's got a job to do after the mistake he made at Estoril, but we'll see how it pans out. This is the perfect recipe for Nicky Hayden to win the title. His teammate's pretty strong, Danny Pedrosa. As I say, not to mention Casey Stoner, Loris Caparossi, Marco Melandri, all between Hayden and Rossi, still in seventh place.
Pedrosa, if Hayden finishes in second place, then Rossi needs to finish no lower than fourth. Hayden would be world champion if it remains the same. Sorry, Mark.
I was just saying the board for Pedrosa is empty. It just says nothing. As Nicky says, 0.5 for Pedrosa, then 0.5 in front of everybody else. So it's funny that Pedrosa gets a board that's just empty. They let him know where he is. He should know about that by now. But all eyes on Rossi as he tries to get all over the back of Casey Stoner. There's the points as it stands if the positions stay until the end of this race.
3 points would give Nicky Hayden the world championship. We didn't think it could get any better. It has. 26 and a half laps ago. Bayliss leads. Hayden second. Marco Melandri up into third. Danny Pedrosa four. Loris Caparossi five. In sixth place, Casey Stoner. He's doing a very, very good job for Honda on his last ride because Rossi at the moment cannot get past him. And I think Hayden is closing down the gap on Bayliss at the front. It's 0.7 seconds. Rossi, you've got to say, Kevin, he's not happy at the moment.
No, certainly not, but he'd settle in if he's pretty cool under pressure. He's got Chris Vermeulen on his tail and Casey Stoner in front of him, Valentino. So he's fairly busy at the moment, starting to look pretty anxious to get past Casey Stoner.
And probably feeling pretty anxious being behind Casey Stoner after what we've seen the last couple of weeks.
Now, Mark, if you get down pit lane, are they telling Valentino Rossi where Nicky Hayden is? I can't believe they will, but I don't know.
I think he can already see that Hayden's well in front of him, Nicky. We wouldn't have to need the pit boards, but I'll just for you, I'll duck down and have a look.
Good, man. But I don't want you to think, you know, it's getting too easy in there.
I'm as nervous as a cat on a hot tin roof.
Across the start and finish line now, it's down to just over 0.3 seconds. Hayden is closing. Hayden is closing. Rossi is in trouble. The Hondas are ganging up at the moment on him.
And there's plenty of them to work together.
Valentino Rossi is going to have to produce the ride of his life if he is going to win the 2006. Oh, Rossi's gone down.
Rossi's down.
Rossi's down. Rossi has crashed out. Rossi has lost the World Championship. Valentino Rossi has crashed out of the Valencia Grand Prix. Nicky Hayden should be crowned world champion.
Unbelievable. Rossi lost it. Four laps into the 30 lapper and Rossi has gone down and out of 37th position. You can see there, just loses the front. Looks like he might have just leaned it right down and just lost traction pretty much simultaneously at both ends, and more specifically the back end, just cracking on the throttle. You can see he just jumps straight up, there.
Just saying, Kev, he's back on the bike. He hasn't given up by any stretch of the imagination, but we wouldn't expect anything less.
No. We wouldn't expect anything less, but the title is gone. If Nicky Hayden can hang in there now, Hayden is going to be crowned world champion. Now, obviously, Mark, just see what sort of ball they're giving Nicky Hayden.
I'm getting there, mate. I'm getting there.
Good.
All Nicky Hayden's got to do now is stay on till he gets around there. The boys will have a message on that board. And Nicky will be able to make sense of that and try and be catching Rossi P20. There you go. Yeah. There you have the information, Nicky Hayden, as he starts to maybe not be so anxious to get into the lead. Loris Caparossi just turned the fastest lap time.
I think Nicky Hayden was thinking about getting past Troy Bayliss there. He was sizing him up as he came out of the left that brought them into the start and finish straight. He saw the board and he went, wow, yep. Let's slow that down. I don't need to do this.
Wound that off. Now, if Bayliss pours on the pressure and Nicky Hayden doesn't have to win, will Troy Bayliss take his maiden win on this ring-in one-off ride on the Desmo Sedici? Could be interesting. One of the Kawasaki's, Depunier, down there. So Randy Depunier down and out, looking like he's fine and trying to get the thing going again. No, he's given up for the day. That's it for his year with the Kawasaki ZX-RR and on board with the Doctor. 25 laps to go. Very long laps for the Doctor indeed.
He's in 19th place at the moment. Valentino Rossi, he's crashed out, would you believe it? A rare mistake by Valentino Rossi. Now, Nicky Hayden was thinking about taking the lead from Troy Bayliss, or trying to. That's taking absolutely nothing away from Troy Bayliss. 12 points would separate Nicky Hayden and Valentino Rossi.
Melandrian Caparossi far from out of it, and Danny Pedrosa lurking there, and we've seen him come pretty strong later in the races too.
So what does Nicky Hayden think now, Kevin? I mean, that board must have caught him by big surprise.
Well, I'd say all those billion butterflies that were battling around inside his gut would have pretty much calmed down now, and now he's just got to keep it together, keep it together.
And the sign he got then was Rossi P19 for Hayden.
And Loris Caparossi moving back in front of Marco Melandri. Of course, these two separated by 8 points in the championship. Loris Caparossi is going to get further in front than that. Loris Caparossi now really closing up on Nicky Hayden. But Nicky Hayden now is concentrating on winning the 2006 MotoGP World Championship, not the Grand Prix of Valencia. Valentino Rossi, 19th at the moment. He's 25.256 seconds behind Troy Bayliss in the lead. He's 6.039 seconds behind Gary McCoy in 18th place. Now, even the doctor can do nothing about this.
Well, many were saying that Nicky Hayden was going to crack under the pressure, and I don't think I heard one person say that Rossi was going to crack under the pressure. Kev, did the pressure get to him?
Well, I'd say that from Bodgen the start, he was trying to recover earlier on, and as Nick said, it's a happier motorcycle at the end of the race when the fuel load's lighter. It was very early in the race, and therefore the fuel load was still quite heavy, and it looked like it was just an error of, but looked like just the lean angle was that much with the heavy fuel load that it just got away from under him, and he was that far leaned over on such a slow turn that that he couldn't gather it back up.
Now, Nicky Hayden, he doesn't want to be involved in all this nonsense, does he, at the front now? They're coming at all angles. From Marco Melandri is there. Loris Caparossi is there. Casey Stoner is still hanging there. Danny Pedrosa, he doesn't really want this, does he?
No, he certainly doesn't. He doesn't need it, but he can be really dictated to by his pit board and just keep that 9 points or more gap.
And Loris Caparossi moves into second place in front of Nicky Hayden. Nicky Hayden isn't too worried about that, I don't think. He's not too worried about it in any way at all. All Nicky Hayden has got to do is keep out of trouble. Rossi crosses the line, 19th place.
Now, while all this has been going on, we've got to give a mention to Bayliss. He's just been got to the front from the first opening seconds of this race, and he's really making him give chase, but doesn't look like they're going to close him down in any hurry too soon.
It's going to be one of those races, though, Mark. Troy Bayliss, it would be a famous victory, but it won't be remembered. The remembering ring will be, if he does it, Nicky Hayden crowned as world champion and Valentino Rossi crashing out, which is cruel, cruel luck for Troy Bayliss. I think it's got a long way to go yet, to be really honest with you. 22 and a half laps. Nicky Hayden in third place. Valentino Rossi in 19th place. That's not even in Dr. Reins's chart, is it?
No.
19th place for Valentino Rossi. Where's Nicky Hayden got to finish? Nobody thought it would happen. It has happened. The incredible has happened. Valentino Rossi has made a mistake. Valentino Rossi is 19th. Nicky Hayden is in third place. If it remains the same, Nicky Hayden will win the World Championship for America.
Now, would have Hayden just buttoned off a bit just to let Caparossi go and let him settle down and get himself a rhythm in third spot?
I would say that would be the case for sure. He doesn't have to get too excited just yet. He knows that Valentino's got 0 points. He only has to beat him by 9 points, which is...
You're doing your maths now.
Ninth place.
Yep.
Now, looking at the times too, guys, Bayliss, Caparossi, Melandri and Pedrosa are all doing 133s that last lap, and Hayden doing a 134.4, so, or 134.1, my apologies. So just a bit off the pace of the rest, but he's probably just regrouping and having a good think about what's here. There's the points on the board at the moment, 52 to 44, so Hayden would win the championship by 8 points, the same deficit he went in there. That's a bit ironic as well.
Well, you can look at the cruel luck, and you only have to go back to 2 weeks ago for Nicky Hayden. Now, it's been Rossi on track in the race, and I guess you'd have to say his own mistake, where Nicky Hayden was 100% not at fault.
So Marco Melandri is currently in fourth place behind Nicky Hayden. They're not in the same team, but they both ride for Honda. But Melandri obviously wants to open up the gap. He wants to get closer to Loris Caparossi to hang on to that third place in the championship. Hayden will not be too disappointed if he goes past. And then he's got Danny Pedrosa behind him then. And you would hope that Danny Pedrosa would protect his back, wouldn't you?
You would certainly expect nothing less after taking Nicky Hayden out in Portugal. And we'll just have to see how it unfolds. He may not need any help from Danny Pedrosa the way it's going at this point. But how about Troy Bayliss? How's he going? Is that the boys over the fence? Go, Troy.
He leads the way by 0.7 seconds from his teammate, Loris Caparossi. Nicky Hayden, the world champion-elect, still in third place. Marco Melandri, 4. Danny Pedrosa, 5. Casey Stoner, 6. Chris Vermeulen, 7. Shinya Nakano, 8. John Hopkins, 9. Colin Edwards, 10. Tony Elias in 11th place. 12th place, Kenny Roberts Jr. And there we are. Valentino Rossi moves up into 18th place in front of the Ilmor of Gary McCoy. This will not be enough from the doctor. He made a rare mistake. He crashed. He's back on the bike. But now Hayden has the championship in his grasp. We have another faller. I think it's one of the Dantin machines, is it? Yes, it is. It's either Cardoso or Hoffman. It's Hoffman, the German. Perfectly okay. End a wretched season for Alex Hoffman. But nobody else was involved. That's what's important at this stage, isn't it?
Very important, and certainly the championship contenders. At this point, Hayden's got it covered. Rossi is in trouble in 18th. He's on his way up the charts, but it's going to take a lot to recover that lost time.
Well, there's a famous saying in racing, isn't there? Hayden can only lose the championship, can't he? Rossi can't win it. Hayden can only lose
it. Yeah, and the shoe was on the other foot at the start of this race, and then a couple of weeks before that it was on the other foot again. So very interesting stuff. We can see there Hayden's gone hard front and medium rear. Melandri's gone medium, and that's an interesting choice for Nicky. So he wants to get the better of Melandri anyway. He's got it at the moment.
I've got Livio Sabo with me from Ducati. All eyes are on the Hayden battle now that Rossi's out, but must make you feel pretty good. 1 and 2. I know there's a long way to go, Livio, but 1 and 2 in the race.
It's a good start of the race. Bayliss is doing a great job, and Loris as well, so let's cross our finger.
And did you expect Bayliss to go out like this?
You know, you never know with Troy. Last time he was here with us, he was on the podium, and I hope he'll do it again.
Okay, thank you, Livio.
I think he's right. Everybody focus on the battle for the championship with a superb performance by the two Ducatis, Bayliss and Caparossi. Rossi has now moved up into 16th place. He's got past James Ellison, but he is still 27 seconds behind Troy Bayliss in the lead. And that's obviously what is very, very important indeed. And Nicky Hayden looking nice and comfortably, isn't he, in third place. That's almost the ideal situation for Nicky Hayden at the moment, isn't it? And Danny Pedrosa, like Senna Marco Melandri, don't you go after him. If you do, I'm going to get after you and give you a bit of a hard time.
Yeah, give you a hard one. And, that'll be interesting. It's just an incredible race, the way it's panning out. But not to mention Troy Bayliss. What about him? The alleged fact was that with superbike riders can't ride MotoGP bikes, and Bayliss seems to be rubbing a bit of mud in the faces of that.
Yeah, I couldn't agree with him more. Superb performance. Here comes Danny Pedrosa, thinking about going up the inside of Melandri. That would be even better, wouldn't it, for Hayden, if Pedrosa could get past Melandri and then just really just slow things up. And it wouldn't be the complete payback. But yeah. What happened in Portugal would disappear pretty quickly if Nicky Hayden wins the championship, wouldn't it?
Now, looking at the last time, too, guys, Hayden had to think about it. He's back down into the 33s. In fact, he was the second fastest bike on the track that last lap besides Caparossi. Caparossi a 33.3, Hayden a 33.4. And Caparossi 310 kilometres an hour going down the straight. And Pedrosa fastest at 311.
I would think that his heart went through his head when he saw that board. They've got to let him know, but He was sizing up Bayliss, wasn't he? He really was.
Yeah.
And here comes Danny Pedrosa up the inside of Marco Melandri.
Ran it wide, wide.
Run it really, really wide. And Casey Stoner's got there now. And no disrespect to Casey Stoner, I'm sure he'd be very careful. But Nicky Hayden really doesn't want Casey Stoner around him in this situation. Oh, Casey Stoner trying to get up now in the inside of Marco Melandri. It's as if he's saying, I don't care. I want to get up there. I want to get on the podium. Right, Marco Melandri is just fighting off Casey Stoner. Danny Pedrosa, you've got to give him his due. He's trying all he can to help Nicky Hayden, isn't he? But then he ran it wide. The two Ducatis getting closer. Nicky Hayden, as I say, I would think his heart went through his head when he saw the board. But they've got to let him know. But they might have just let him know a little bit quick as we see Pedrosa here.
And that's Pedrosa just straight up the inside of Marco Melandri, carrying a monstrous amount of speed. No, Danny, you're not going to get there. You managed to keep it on the track, out on this greasy bit of the track. Another rider down, the one at the
it's
other.
Cardoso, I think they're both out of the race now.
Hayden's board telling him exactly what's going on. Plus 1.7 over Melandri, so he knows exactly where he is. He's about 0.9 of a second, nearly a second behind Caparossi. So if he can just settle in there, just run the race that he wants to without doing anything. They're all still in the 33s except for Melandri. Melandri, Stoner and Pedrosa dropping down 34s, which would have been slowed up by that little altercation they had.
Rossi has now moved into 14th place. So he's making his way up through the field. He's actually dropping back, though, time-wise on the battle at the front, because he's 28 seconds down at the moment. He's picking off the people that aren't so difficult for a world champion to pick off, but he's not making any sort of progress on the Baileys, Caparossi's, and most important, not on Nicky Hayden.
No, you wouldn't imagine he'll get that close, but third race distance just passed, and we've got to see what Valley can dig out of the gravel heap, if you like, where he ended up on the fourth lap, I think it was, and Casey Stoner taking a real tight line into there and looking like he's going to have a go at Melandri, but I think it's just his line. He's gone with a hard front tyre after losing the front this morning in warm-up.
Now, the next board that Nicky Hayden's going to get is Rossi, P14. Oh, Chris Vermeulen out.
Chris Vermeulen out. There's just 6 points behind between them at the moment. You told me about there's Chris Vermeulen going down, coming onto the start and finish straight. He's perfectly okay. That's the main thing. Well, you told me, Kev, you did maths, you're a good mathematician, but 6 points isn't quite as many as I thought it might have been, to be really honest with you.
No, we'll say that's Nicky now sitting in third, just getting 16 points for that, with an 8-point lead, and Rossi starting to get up there and in 14th now grabbing the two, so we guess it just cuts it in half, and then with Rossi getting 2 points, it's back to six, so that's the reality of it, but he's got to make another six positions to bring the thing to a draw, and seven to take the title.
Now look at this, guys. Hayden's really closed up on Caparossi. He got that P14 sign. He thought, all right, I better get up the second so I can get another 4 points on Valentino Rossi.
I think you're absolutely right, Mark. I've got to be honest, that caught me a bit by surprise. Yeah. I suddenly saw 6 points. I thought it was a bigger gap than that, but it's not. And Hayden looks very, very quick indeed, doesn't he? And he's thinking, I'd rather be in second place and just up it up once again. So there's absolutely no chance of a miracle ride by Valentino Rossi.
Yeah, as soon as Hayden can cement second from Caparossi, that gives him the 4 more points. And where Valentino is, each rider he passes, he'll only pick up 1 point. So yep, he's got to pass 4 riders to make up for what Nicky Hayden's put on him by passing Caparossi and moving into second.
And the closest rider to him, Carlos Checa, he's 14 seconds in front of Rossi at the moment. So he's got a lot to make up. Be interesting to see if Checa gets aboard to say to slow down and let Rossi in front.
May well do, but it's a thankless task. I think, as I said, Nicky Hayden can only lose the World Championship. Valentino Rossi can't win it, and I think that's going to be the situation. They're telling him he's in 14th place. What must he be thinking in that helmet, Kevin?
I think it's called changes of fortune. We've seen him to and fro for the last couple of weeks, and Valentino's weren't that great during different points in the year, like Le Mans, Laguna, Jerez at the first round, and it's turned out to be an absolute cracker of the last round, and Rossi in the gravel, and Troy Bayliss leading, and Nicky Hayden still sitting in third place, but looking to go for Caparossi's scalp.
We ride with the doctor. We ride with the doctor probably for the last time as world champion in MotoGP. Loris Caparossi coming under increasing pressure now from Nicky Hayden. He's recovered from the shock when the board told him that Valentino Rossi was down in 20th place. He's really on the pace once again, and he wants to get past Caparossi just to give absolutely not a sniff of a chance for Valentino Rossi. It is only a sniff of a chance anyway. It's virtually impossible, but he just wants to cement it. Everything has gone against him since Laguna Seca. At last, when it really, really matters, that little bit of change of fortune's come his way.
You got to get lucky sometime, and I guess it's Nicky's day at this point in time. As long as he can keep his act together, he'll be right. It's certainly looking that way, but we'll see what Rossi's got in store.
I've got Hervé Poncharel from the Tech 3 Yamaha team, Carlos Checa's team. Carlos having a good battle with Tomata, but Hervé, will you tell Carlos that Rossi's closing the gap and getting to slow if he gets close to him?
I think I didn't hear your question, but I can imagine what you asked me. At the moment, Valentino is 15 seconds behind Carlos, and Tamara is in between them two. So if by the end of the race, of course, Carlos is just in front of Valentino, and that could be the difference. Of course, we will signboard Carlos, but at the moment, that's not the situation.
And one of the biggest shocks of the year, if not the last 20 years, with Rossi crashing out.
Yeah, what to say, it's crazy.
Okay, that's something. I think that sums it all up with Hervé, actually.
Well, he's summed up the season there, hasn't he, Hervé? Yeah, Valentin Rossi, a bit of a lonely 14th at the moment, isn't he? And Hervé got it absolutely right. Well, sure he will. He's the team manager. No point in giving Carlos Checa anything to worry about at the moment, is there? Because he's not close enough. Hayden and Caparossi, I'd say, are closing on Bayliss a bit, aren't they?
Certainly looks that way. And Rossi's actually dropping back. Bayliss is getting away from Rossi. It's out to 29.3 seconds now. So Rossi has certainly got the job ahead of him, but it's all about Nicky Hayden, who's only 1 second behind Troy Bayliss. So it's still 28 seconds to there. So the assets that Rossi's got in that field is Colin Edwards sitting in 11th and Carlos Checa in 12th, who could jump out of the way. That's why it really is in Nicky Hayden's interest to put time on Loris Caparossi and maybe even set out after Troy Bayliss.
Well, Bayliss now, he's just eked it out a bit, 0.7 at the end of that lap. He's now out to nearly 0.9 of a second over Caparossi. So we'll just be interesting to see if this battle between Hayden and Caparossi actually slows him down and lets Bayliss consolidate even more.
14 laps to go. 14 laps of the 2.5 mile Ricardo Tormo circuit for Nicky Hayden to be crowned the 2006 MotoGP World Champion. John Hopkins and Colin Edwards, the two Americans. Hopkins in 10th place, Colin Edwards 11th, and another American in 9th place. It's Kenny Roberts Jr. But it's a Honda, it's a Suzuki, and it's Rossi's teammate. He might get past the one, but the others are not going to make life easy for him, are they?
Definitely not. They're all out to get the best result they can for themselves in the last race of the season. But yeah, just over half race distance, and who would have thought that Rossi would be smack dead on 30 seconds behind Troy Bayliss last time over the line, and Nicky Hayden would be exactly 1.2 seconds behind Troy Bayliss himself. So not looking good for Valentino, currently in 14th with the 2 points. So that championship gap, it still remains as a 6-point deficit to Rossi, so we'll see what he can do.
Bayliss still leads the way. We look at Rossi. Kenny Roberts, Tony Elias, Shinya Nakano, Casey Stoner, Danny Pedrosa. Slightly further down the field, there's Kenny Roberts. Here is Colin Edwards battling it out with John Hopkins at the moment. American pride at stake. But American pride at stake really doesn't matter, because that would go out of the window if Nicky Hayden wins the world title. Over the start and finish line they come, 13 laps to go. At nearly 9/10 of a second, here comes Danny Pedrosa, decided that he really must help Nicky Hayden. He's got past Casey Stoner. How many times have the auto had a battle in the 250cc class? He sets after Marco Malandri, but Bayliss has increased that lead at the front to just under 9/10 of a second.
I'm feeling really lucky today, guys. I've got Pete Benson with me. Pete, what would have been going through Nicky Hayden's mind there when he saw that sign that you said he was out?
Well, he's not out, we didn't tell him that, but you know, it's still not over and there's still 13 laps to go. And where we're at the moment, I think if Valentino picks up another 3 or 4 places, we could still be in trouble. So there's a long way to go and I'm not making any bets.
Well, he slowed his pace down a bit when he first got that board to let know Rossi had his accident, but he's settled into a good rhythm now.
I don't think he really slowed his pace down. I think, you know, it's just probably the pace that he can do without sort of sticking his neck out too far. But obviously we want to, you know, still try and win the race and make a real good ending to the season.
Well, hopefully I'll talk to you later on.
Yeah, I'll try and be in a better mood than last week.
Pete Benson, the crew chief for Nicky Hayden, who was not in a good mood in Portugal. Who can blame him? But this is a tense tie. There's 12.5 laps to go. Loris Caparossi still in second place. It's Nicky Hayden right behind him. There's Bayliss who leads. Hayden, I think, probably will have a go, don't you, Kevin? I think he just wants to make sure that there's no chance of Valentino Rossi doing something at the very last minute.
Yeah, he can't do much more than what he's doing right now. 12 laps to go, and Bayliss is still within striking distance over that kind of many laps. And Caparossi's got, as we said, 4 points in the bag. The Ilmor back into the pits, so looks like Gaz still there in the helmet. Looks like they're changing the rear wheel, so probably head back out and continue the testing, which is basically what they're doing with the Ilmor 800, testing in public at the last two Grand Prix. The best testing you could ever get is at a MotoGP race itself. Started back on the side of it, so I think he was going to fire that up and head out with a new rear tyre. But yeah, Nicky Hayden can't really do any more than this, because He knows Loris Caparossi. Rossi's got to pass four more guys. At the moment, Rossi's got to pass six guys in front of him, which means making 20 seconds on Tony Elias, who he was only 0.2 of a second, a lap faster than last time round. So the maths don't indicate Rossi can do it, but this is one championship we haven't been able to calculate. It's been a moving set of goalposts for the last few rounds. Well, in fact, all year. Here's Danny Pedrosa on his teammate.
He's got up the inside of Marco Melandri, and I think he's going to take over fourth place. Danny Pedrosa. Whoa, it's hot there, isn't it? Has he done it? No, he hasn't. Melandri on the brakes. Yes, he has. Danny Pedrosa has gone through. It just gets better by the minute, doesn't it, for Nicky Hayden?
Now, yeah. I've got Eskil Suter with me from the Ilmor team. Eskil, looked like just a tyre change, but a bit more dramatic than that.
It's not a tyre change. They just changed the tyre in case you go out again. Gary felt we dropped some power for some reason, but we really don't know what happens exactly at the moment. We just analysed.
Well, that's what happens when you test it. What happens when you're testing when you're racing, I suppose.
The race so far goes very well. He closed up on Ellison and he was below 2 seconds of the race pace, so it's a shame. It's a very good race so far.
Well, looking forward to seeing you back here next year.
Thank you very much.
They are the Ilmor team having a few problems, but who wouldn't? They're testing in front of the gaze of the world, and they're doing a very, very good job indeed. Loris Caparossi, the gap between him and Nicky Hayden, well, it's 1/10 of a second. You don't really need to look at that, do you? Just look at the pictures. He's very, very close indeed, Nicky Hayden. Bayliss has opened the gap up between him himself and Caparossi by 1 second. So Troy Bayliss really is on course, dare we say, for his first ever MotoGP victory. That would be a sensational performance.
Well, exactly. Not only that, just go back to the 250s for a moment. Alex De Angelis won his first race. Jorge Lorenzo won the world championship, and we may have the similar thing here. If Troy Bayliss can pull off the win and Nicky Hayden can win the title, it would be amazing that Troy would get his first win here under these kind of circumstances with this fight for the world championship. Obviously, that Rossi would end up in the gravel on top of that.
Now, Hayden getting the lap board that he's 4.9 seconds in front of his teammate Pedrosa as they come past to complete this lap. It'd be interesting to see if Hayden just sits there and know when they tell him that Rossi's moving up, if he makes a move on Caparossi, he'll be quite happy to sit in third place.
Yeah, and it's just 0.8 of a second now between Bayliss and Caparossi. So perhaps Caparossi's going to have one more go at Troy Bayliss, but he's ridden an absolutely superb race at the front. Valentino Rossi hasn't even arrived through the start and finish yet, so it is looking good for Nicky Hayden. There are 10 laps remaining.
Now, here's a scenario for you too, guys. As Caparossi stays in second spot, I presume he'll overtake Melandri for third. But if he's not, is there a team order going to come out for Bayliss to slow down and let Caparossi win the race?
We're too worried about the championship.
You would have to deal with David Tardozzi to get that one through as we look again at Rossi going down in the early laps. So hangs onto the bars as long as he can. He's already back on his feet, or almost back on his feet, before the bike stops sliding. You can see there the amount of lean angle, and he's just lost it. It's pretty much, there's out of traction. There's no traction down there. And Valentino's in the... That's the reaction in the HRC garage, Nicky Hayden's crew. And just can't believe it.
No.
Bit different than last week.
They are 6 points still with a gap. Do you know what that corner is called where he crashed? It's the Mick Doohan corner. So they are both on 5 Premier Class wins. Mick's shining down from above. Well, saying, no, I don't want him to have his sick.
He gave up on that one, did he? But Rossi's still got the job ahead of him. 30 seconds down on Bayliss. But the problem is he's got 10 seconds till he catches 13th place Makoto Tomata, and that's only for 1 point. And lap time wise, took 7/10 out of Makoto last lap round, so he's obviously not got enough laps on that mathematical calculation, but he has to pass another 5 guys in front of that, 6 guys in fact, to pick up the extra 7 points.
Danny Pedrosa in third place. Casey Stoner having a good ride. Sorry, in fourth place. Casey Stoner having a good ride. Fifth. Marco Melandri in sixth place. Shinya Nakano. Kenny Roberts Jr. coming late now, just as he did in Portugal, up into eighth. Ninth is Tony Elias. 10th, John Hopkins. 11th, Colin Edwards. 12th, Carlos Checa. 13th, Makoto Tomada. And in 14th place, Valentino Rossi.
Now, Nicky Hayden looks like he's just playing it pretty cool. 34 even last lap round. 33.6 for Caparossi, or 33.62 and 33.614 for Bayliss, respectively. So Troy Baylor still putting the laps down and using every bit of track through the centre section of Valencia before he gets into the 180 and heads back to the other end of the circuit, starting the final half of the lap. Nine laps to go, so two-thirds race distance already gone. And Caparossi doing his best to nab that win from Troy Bayliss.
Caparossi certainly is closing a little bit. Nicky Hayden, I'm absolutely convinced you're right now. He's got it sorted in his head where he wants to stay. He's got Danny Pedrosa behind him just protecting him nicely. He knows from his pit boards that Perossi's not going to pull something, a miracle out at the end of the race. And they cross the line now. There's eight laps to go. The gap between Bayliss, who leads the way, and Caparossi is half a second. So that's the closest they've been probably since almost the start of the race.
Yep, he's just inching back up to him. But if they stayed the way they are, Loris Caparossi would take third place in the championship standings off Marco Melandri by 2 points. So we'll just see what these Ducati teammates got in store for us in the closing laps of this last MotoGP of 2007. But it's all Bayliss at the moment, but Caparossi's threatening.
Yeah, and Mark, you were just saying, sorry to butt in, Mark, but you were saying, you know, it just to make it a little bit safer for Caparossi to take third place, Ducati might really want Caparossi to win the race just to cement it, mightn't they?
Yeah, I'll go back up there in a minute. I'm just down at the Suzuki garage with Kevin Schwantz. Kevin, who would have believed that this would unfold like this?
Yeah, you never would have guessed that finishing third would be enough to win that championship, and I think Nicky and Rossi were both thinking the same thing. One pushed a little too hard too early, and now he's got to try and hope for some misfortune up front.
Well, you've been there before, mate, winning a world championship. What would Hayden be thinking at the moment?
Well, he's hearing every little sound that engine's making. He's feeling things with the tire. He's just begging for these laps to come to an end. And, you know, he's done a great job all season long. A little misfortune with his teammate last weekend. But he's doing a great job today.
I know you're a Suzuki man through and through, but you might duck down and have a drink in the Honda pit.
Yeah, you know, Nicky's done a great job, like I just said. Hats off to him if he pulls off another eight laps.
Thanks, Kevin.
See you.
I think Kevin Swans is here, isn't he? Of course, the last American to win the Premier Class title, Kenny Roberts Jr. in 2000 on a 500cc Suzuki. And Nicky Hayden would be the first man in the MotoGP class, and he would be the last 990cc MotoGP world champion. I hope he can't hear all this, because he would not thank me for saying it, would he, Kevin?
The curse of the commentators. We'll see what he can do. He's not connected to us, so it's all in his hands. He's doing his best at the moment, and his best is certainly more than good enough at the moment, with Rossi still down in 14th place, just went over the start-finish line then, 32 seconds behind Bayliss now, so not really making any inroads there. 9 seconds behind Tomata. So he's closed the gap down to Makoto Tomata by 1 second in the last few laps.
And Gary McCoy on the Ilmor heading back out again to have another go and bring it home.
Yeah, it's not going to happen for Rossi. It's all down now to the 25-year-old American from Owensboro in Kentucky. The world championship is in his grasp.
I've got David Todd Dotsie with me. David, with Troy leading the race, which I'm sure you're very happy about, is there team orders to let Caparossi into the lead to make sure he gets third in the championship?
We will see. The race is not finished yet, then we will take a decision at the right moment.
But you must be pretty happy with the way it's unfolded.
Yeah. He's giving us a dream.
Well, he said it all. To them, it's a dream. So, well, keep a close eye on that later on the race and see what does eventuate. But I think in his words, he might have alluded to it. The team orders might just come out.
There we go. He's given the whole of Australia a dream, I think. He's certainly giving World Superbikes a dream. Nicky Hayden's got all of North America waiting to celebrate a dream. This is going to be a very, very tense last 5.5 laps here in Valencia. The last 5.5 laps of the season. Can Nicky Hayden do it and win the world title back for America?
Certainly looking good at this stage, with Rossi again just going over the line, up into 13th now.
It's Casey Stoner
that's gone.
Yeah,
out.
Casey Stoner's dropped a lap. It's Casey Stoner down in 14th place at the moment, so I don't know if he had a moment. We certainly don't think he's crashed out. He might have run off the track, he might have a mechanical problem. But Casey Stoner now dropping down further through the field. So obviously a problem for Casey Stoner in his last ride for the LCR Honda team.
3 points for Rossi out of 13th position and 16 for Nicky Hayden. So 13 the difference. So Hayden will take the title by 5 points at this stage of the race, if you like. And the championship race itself is just about over, not to mention this last round.
Michael Jordan looks on, a big, big fan of Nicky Hayden. He's come here with his entourage. I don't think he's probably seen more dramatic events than this. And Loris Caparossi is closing. Be interesting, Mark, to see if they do hang the board out or if just Troy Bayliss's tyres perhaps just going off a little bit. But Caparossi is closing on him.
I haven't got the point scores with me at the moment, Nick, but it'd be interesting to see what Caparossi was behind, and I can do the sums from there.
And he was 8 points behind Marco Melandri. And if he finishes it, obviously he's going to be fine if he wins the race. So let's wait and see. But this is all about Nicky Hayden, the man that was leading the World Championship by 51 points when he went on his summer break at home in America after winning the American Grand Prix at Laguna Seca. It was cut and dried as far as Valentino Rossi was concerned.
Just doing my sums, Nick, if Caparossi stays where he is and Melandri stays where he is, Caparossi will get second by 1 point.
There you go. By third.
Third, sorry, by 1 point.
And that's not because we're clever. It just flashed up on the screen as you said it. Because we would have agreed with you, I think, because it's all pretty frantic up here. Look at the marks there on Valentino Rossi's yellow leathers, where he went down. It was on the left side, I think, down the thigh, yeah. Wasn't it, Kevin?
Yeah, just real fairly low speed. And as you said, Nick, in doing corner, first gear turn and just low-sided, just pushing a little bit harder too early with a full tank of fuel, and unfortunately took the sting out of the championship from his point of view, but half delivered it back to Nicky Hayden. But all Hayden's got to do is continue exactly what he's doing and finish where he is, and it'll be all his by 5 points.
Four laps ago. Nicky Hayden, I think it was Kevin Swans was saying, he'll just be praying for it to end. Just please, please end. It must be, is it the longest four laps? It's the longest 6 minutes of his life?
Yeah, well, as we said, between the siding lap and the warm-up lap when the riders sit on the grid there for 10 or so minutes, and Nicky Hayden would have just wanted to get it underway, as do most of the riders. But Nicky Hayden, especially being in the pain, and no, not physical pain or literal pain, just the mental pain from being taken out by his teammate Danny Pedrosa 2 weeks ago, coming to the last round with an 8 point deficit instead of a 12 point lead to Valentino Rossi. And you wouldn't credit Rossi making a mistake at the last round under pressure, but it certainly has been the way it's worked out. And here we've got Nicky Hayden looking at his first and the very last 990 MotoGP World Championship.
There we go, Valentino Rossi in 13th place. We see that on the screen, and that's just going to be told to Nicky Hayden when he comes across the line with three laps ago. He's been there the whole time. He's been there in the good times, and his father Earl's been there in the bad times, and he's always been there for Nicky. This will be some time to celebrate. Both his brothers are here, his mum's here, his older sister's here. I don't think they can look now, do you? I think I'd have to go away. And I think, Kevin, first time for 30 years, I'd have to light up a fag, to be honest with you.
I think that'd be like every time their heart beats, it'd be like a hand grenade going off each time inside their chest, because that'd be that tense for Nicky. But he certainly got things under control and is riding a very heady race. He's not getting too excited about Caparossi and Troy Bayliss out front. He doesn't have to. Sitting in third, 16 points, not a problem for him at this point in time. And just keep your act together, Nicky. He said he had all the chips on the table and he was all in with a question mark on the last of the Royal Flush cards, and he's looking pretty Royal Flush at the moment.
What a year it's been for Nicky Hayden, the 25-year-old American, running away with the championship. We thought he was home and dry. Neil Valentino Rossi didn't, and he had problems with the clutch. And then the disaster, when I think I've never seen a man so angry in my whole life as Nicky Hayden. But he's strong, he's got great mental character, he's a really good guy. Somehow he managed to put that behind him and get out here in absolute 100% fitness, 100% psychologically right. Qualifying didn't go too good for him. He was on the second row of the grid, wasn't he? But he did it when it mattered.
Now, Hayden's pit board is telling him that Rossi is in 13th spot, but P3 is okay, so he knows exactly what's going on.
He doesn't want to... Yeah. I have trouble sitting up here with all bits of paper and a pen. He doesn't want to be starting to work that out,
well,
does he?
If you think that Nicky might be nervous, you should see the pit here. Pete Benson's pretty calm, cool and collected as always. But a lot of his crew, they're pacing around. They're not looking at the screen. They're just... every second must be like torture as we look at Cap Rossi. Maybe a deceiving angle of how close he is behind his teammate Bayliss at the moment, 0.7 of a second, so it's still been pretty even over these last few laps.
Yeah, and Troy Bayliss has been able to take a couple of tenths again out of Rossi and of Caparossi in the last couple of laps. So Bayliss responding to the threat of Caparossi getting close and trying to make a pass. As we look at Tony Elias, he's sitting in sixth place, so good rate result for him just behind his teammate Marco Melandri, about 3 seconds behind Melandri. It's back to Hayden, third place will do it for him. It would give him that title.
Let's have a quick run through before chaos descends here. Bayliss leads, Caparossi second. Come on, Earl, we're with you. You're going to win it.
Look at the screen, Earl.
Hayden in third place. Pedrosa, four. Melandri, five. Elias, six. Nakano, seven. Roberts Jr., eight. Edwards, nine. Checker, 10. Hopkins, 11. Tamada, 12. Valentino Rossi in 13th place. They're the only ones who have crossed the line so far. Casey Stoner is obviously out of the race because he's five laps down.
You just saw Earl Hayden's face, but he's got his legs crossed. Yes. Both hands have got his fingers crossed on him. He's just hoping and hoping. He's not game enough to look at anything.
Here we go. This is it. 2.500 miles between Nicky Hayden and the 2006 MotoGP World Championship. Bayliss leads, Caparossi in second place. They're getting him on a back marker there, which will not please him. I don't think Nicky Hayden wants to get anywhere near him, do you?
No, certainly not. Just get around him and escape as quick as possible. If the positions remain the same and the Yamaha boys bandied together and Colin Edwards pulled out a ninth or rolled off in ninth and let Rossi by, and Checker did the same out of 10th. Valentino Rossi would gain two extra places but still win the championship by only three.
Hayden would win the championship, yeah, by...
Sorry, Hayden would win the championship still by 3 points.
Nicky Hayden's mum.
It's all mathematical.
She's got the fingers crossed. He's on his last lap.
Rossi's 7 seconds behind Tomato, who's behind Hopkins, who's now behind Checker. So that scenario will definitely not unfold at the moment.
If you're at home in the States, cross those fingers. Join Earl Hayden, join Mrs. Hayden, join the brothers, join the family, join the whole of Owensboro in Kentucky. He's just under a minute away from clinching the world title. Let's take anything away from Troy Bayliss. What a ride by the Australian. The world superbike champion. He's come back to MotoGP and he has shown them what world superbike is all about.
Ducati first and second on top of that with Caparossi sitting there. And what a day for the team.
Troy Bayliss crosses the line. Troy Bayliss wins the Grand Prix of Valencia. Loris Caparossi in second place. But ladies and gentlemen, salute the 2006 MotoGP world champion. It's the American, Nicky Hayden.
Well, look at that. You can just see the relief on it. He'd be in tears at the moment. He wouldn't be believing it. He was punching the air at the light. Anyway, we've seen them come across. Now they can celebrate that Rossi's still in 13th position. Pete Benson getting the hugs of all concerned, but Pete... what a difference 2 weeks makes.
Oh, fuck. I mean, you know, it's been up and down like you wouldn't believe the last 2 weeks. And it's been a bit nerve-wracking today, but I guess we had a bit of luck, I guess you could say.
Well, swings and roundabouts, but still a good race.
Yeah, exactly. You know, you got to take them when you can.
All right, congratulations, mate. Thanks again.
Thanks, mate.
It's great to hear Pete Benson, another man that talks to you, whatever the situation, good or bad. The crew chief for the world champion, Nicky Hayden. Danny Pedrosa did a really good job in fourth place, and I saw him go straight up to Nicky Hayden as they're riding alongside each other and pat him on the helmet, and
pandemonium.
I think a big relief for him.
Pandemonium in the Repsol Honda crew. Lucio Cecchinello's in here. Everybody's here at the moment.
Kenny Roberts Jr., look at that. No need to say any more, is there? Valentino Rossi comes up alongside Nicky Hayden and shakes his hand.
Oh, it just shows you the respect that they've got for each other.
And Kenny Roberts was the man to shake his hand before that. And Kenny Roberts, the last American to win the Premier Class
the wheel,
title. Yeah, he's got to be careful with that flag in the wheel. Please.
He's got it worked out now.
There we go. Look at this. Valentino Rossi crashing out on lap 4 of this vital race, getting back to eventually finish in 13th place. It wasn't even enough for the doctor. Kevin, have you ever seen two races like the last two?
No, that's just been incredible. Look at the marshals there bowing to Nicky Hayden, 2006 World MotoGP champion. And no, it's just been an amazing turn of events right from when Rossi got taken out in race one at Jerez at the start of the season. And I mean, it's just topped and turned
now,
and
I've
been
got,
crazy.
I've got Earl Hayden with me. Earl, words can't describe it. What, you know, it's unbelievable, but it is believable.
I guess now it is believable. Well, I tell you, it's fantastic. I can't believe it. I cannot believe it.
What was going through your head those last couple of laps? You had the fingers crossed, the legs crossed.
Everything, toes, everything. Just what he's worked for his whole life.
This is going to America. Have you got anything to say back home?
Well, I'm just glad he's got all the American fans behind him. I love the place. My daughter Kathleen, I want to say hello to her and see you later.
Enjoy it, Earl. Enjoy it.
We'll see you later, Earl. Here we go. Nicky Hayden just cannot believe it. He's in tears. We saw tears 2 weeks ago. These weren't the same tears as we are seeing now. Let's celebrate with the world champion. It's almost sad, isn't it, for Troy Bayliss? I feel really sorry for him. Congratulations, Troy Bayliss. That was the ride of a true champion. Now, let's just see. Gracious in defeat. He will thank everybody.
I've got
a great world champion. So just to say, great world champion is as good in defeat as he is in victory. Sorry, Mark.
I've got Kenny Roberts Sr. with me. Kenny, your son was the last American to win a world championship. A bit less dramatic than this, but what a race.
It's been so long, I forgot. No, what a race, yeah. I can only stand about that much excitement at my age.
What did you think? We could just believe it when Rossi went out of the game? Could you believe it when Rossi went out of the game?
Yeah. Well, you know what? You know, it's not easy riding these things at that level, and obviously I didn't think his thing was working extremely well, and one little hiccup puts it down on the ground.
All right, go and enjoy it with the rest of the Honda boys.
Thank you.
Danny Pedrosa, he looks a little bit happier than he did 2 weeks ago. Helped his teammate. First to congratulate him. I won't say will all be forgotten, but when you win a world title, you can forget most things. The American flag flies proudly over his shoulder. And, well, what a ride. Loris Caparossi in second place. That's clinched third place in the championship for him. He'll be happy. A superb ride by Troy Bayliss to win the race. But this is the man of the day. This is the man of the season. This is Nicky Hayden.
Well, I'm quite surprised, guys. I'm just headed down to the Camel Yamaha garage, and I thought the doors would be shut, but they're open. There's a massive people. There'll be 200 people standing outside the garage trying to get a glimpse of him. There's no way I'm going to get in there. I'll get mugged before I get in there with the rest of them. But I thought the doors would have come straight down. But just showing what a true champion Valentino Rossi is, you'd think many would just go and hide in the corner, but not him.
Well, as I say, how you are in defeat shows an awful lot about your character and what a great champion you are. But this is the current world champion. He's making his way back to Parc Fermé. Earl Hayden, I'm sure, will be one of the first. Oh, wow, he's going.
It is party time now, Nicky Hayden.
Well, actually, when I've got closer to the garage, Rossi is not in the garage. The team's there, but no one else is. Rossi's aunt disappeared out the back by the look of it.
That's his brothers. They're there.
And if you think I'm going to go to Park Firma, you've just got rocks in your head as well. It's just pandemonium down there as well.
There we go. The Ducati people coming across to congratulate Nicky Hayden. Again, that's what it's all about. Everybody wants to win, but Rossi gracious in defeat. But don't make any bones about this. Don't anybody doubt it. Nicky Hayden is a very, very worthy world champion.
No doubt whatsoever. I mean, it's to and fro there quite a bit. Rossi's had a bit of bad luck. Nicky's had a little bit of bad luck. And, you know, by the time you balance it all out, Nicky won the thing, and it was only just. And Rossi give it back in some way, if you like.
He's going to meet his mum any moment now, and I'm sure the tears are going to flow then. Mum's on her way. He looks... He just can't believe he's done it, can he?
Oh, yeah. He's, just totally overwhelmed, you'd have to say. But, and just enjoying the moment. Now there's the kisses and cuddles from mum.
It's his sister. Where's Earl? We haven't seen Earl yet. I don't know if he's recovered.
Yeah, he's still trying to untie the knots he tied himself in.
Yeah.
Crossed everything.
There's Troy Bayliss. Congratulations, Troy Bayliss. That was a magnificent ride by you. Getting hugs from all the team members. They've been through hell the last few weeks. And they've stuck together. There's been some pretty big things going on behind the garage doors. There's been a few things banging around, a few harsh words said, but they've stuck together. They've never come out in public about it, and they've done it.
And that's what it's about. It's about the team and the way the team works when it's in trouble. That's when the team's all got to bandy together and get through that situation. It's not only the rider riding the bike, it's all the guys back in the pit shed as well.
There's the American flag. There's the world championship. I think it's a basketball vest, isn't it? There we go.
Yeah, got the Kentucky kid on the back of that one.
Yeah, father and son, that world championship duo. And Earl is already thanking people, isn't he? That's Earl Hayden all the way around, isn't it?
Yeah, what's he got on the hat? Second chance.
That's his second chance auto, yeah. Never misses a chance to advertise. He's a car lot back home.
Well, speaking of cars, the car that Nicky Hayden won for the BMW for the qualifying award, he's actually giving that to the team so they can sell it and split the proceeds. But hopefully Earl Hayden doesn't buy it because they won't get much money for it.
It's confirmation of the results. Troy Bayliss is maiden MotoGP victory in his one and only appearance of the season. Fabulous. Loris Caparossi in second place, enough to give him third place in the championship. But the big result, third place to Nicky Hayden, makes him the world champion. Valentino Rossi crashing out on lap 4, remounting the bike in typical Valentino Rossi style. But 13th place, not enough for him to retain that title. There we go. 5 points between them at the finish. Caparossi getting in front of Marco Melandri by a single point. Danny Pedrosa fifth. What a season by him. Kenny Roberts Jr. Superbia sixth. Colin Edwards, Casey Stoner and Tony Elias. But it's the man at the top that matters. The stars and stripes are being prepared because Nicky Hayden is the world champion here in Spain. I think we need a breather, don't we? God, what a performance, what a race, what a day, what a season.
A bit like that, it's pretty much breathtaking. And I mean, the way that championship has panned out, you know, from the start to the finish, it's just been such a controversial and very interesting championship. And we all thought that Rossi was going to come home like a steamroller, but it just wasn't to be.
Valencia, the perfect setting for the showdown of the decade. And what a showdown it turned out to be. We've had a great year, ladies and gentlemen, resulting in a fantastic final race. Anybody who hasn't enjoyed MotoGP this year, well, I really don't think you're enjoying any form of motorsport. It really does not get better than that.
Yeah, if you haven't enjoyed that, you haven't got a pulse.
There we go. And Troy Bayliss, what a performance by the Australian. One and only appearance in MotoGP. This year, he's the World Superbike Champion, and he has won the Grand Prix of Valencia.
He's cooling down there, tipping the water. down the leathers, 153 kilometres an hour average speed.
You feeling a bit better now? Could be a few beers later on, I think, Troy, but congratulations. You've done yourself, you've done Australia, and I got to say, you've done the World Superbike Championship. Really proud this afternoon.
And what a way to cap off his year, winning the title and then winning the last 990 MotoGP against that kind of competition just shows the true depth of Troy Bayliss's talent.
Well, he won't have any trouble finding his way to the podium. The last time he was here in the GPs, he was on the way to the podium as well, but not quite with the same intensity and result as this one.
You think she's phoning home?
Definitely got some good news there.
Yeah. Hold the line a minute. We've just got a little bit of news for you. Oh, yeah, but Nicky's won the World Championship. There we are. Two Ducatis and the Honda. The podium awaits. And I think it's nice that Nicky Hayden's on the podium. What a day it has turned out to be. Danny Pedrosa wishes his teammate luck. Nicky Hayden's ready for battle, as is Valentino Rossi, and Colin Edwards wishes him luck. It's the two gladiators. This is it. There's nothing more Jerry Burgess and the team can do. But it's a bad, bad start by Rossi from the line. He bogs it. Troy Bayliss gets a good start. Nicky Hayden makes a decent start. Danny Pedrosa makes an even better start. Hayden and Rossi actually touch elbows going down into turn one. Now, if they'd both gone down, I think I'd have fallen out the commentary box window.
Yeah, look, it's just been right on. That was Nicky Hayden and going under Danny Pedrosa in turn two when Danny made life easy for Nicky to gain the position. Rossi chasing Stoner there and Vermeulen bringing up the rear behind. Doctor.
We ride with the Doctor. I think the moment is about to approach. As Kenny Roberts said, watching the race, we just spoke to him, he said he never, never looked that happy. He's going to look unhappy at any moment. Now there he goes, loses the front end, tips it down. My God, he's up on his feet quick. For that was the moment Valentino Rossi lost the 2006 MotoGP World Championship.
That was the reaction of the two crews, the Yamaha crews first, and now the Honda guys, they just cannot believe it. It's like, what? We fell into our laps. But Nicky Hayden and the crew have worked hard for it all year. Caparossi, the inside there.
Probably exactly what Yamaha were thinking of Portugal. It all fell into their lap, but not for too long.
Yep, that's right. Well, as soon as they got it, they lost it, and vice versa. That was Randy Dipunio tipping the Kawasaki over there. Rossi,
Rossi making his way back through the field. He's trying to get past Gary McCoy on the Ilmor. That's Alex Hoffman down in the dirt. Rossi gets past James Ellison, but he's not picking up enough points. And that's Chris Vermeulen going down big style. He's perfectly okay, I'm happy to say. And this is Danny Pedrosa. Danny Pedrosa thinks, I've really, really got to help my teammate after Estoril. And he gets it into fourth place in front of Marco Melandri. And that's just perfect timing. Loris Caparossi closing on Bayliss at the front. But Troy Bayliss is not going to be shifted from the front, is he?
No, that was certainly an opportunity that Troy doesn't know whether he'll ever get again. It was invitation to replace Sede Gibernau, and he was in position to win. So when the pressure come on from behind and teammate Caparossi, he just responded and won the thing. And there's the reaction from the team as he heads over the line, and Nicky Hayden, third, becomes world champion.
That picture, ladies and gentlemen, sums it up perfectly. 5 points between them, a shake of the hands between the world champion and the world champion from 2005. He might do his Valentino Rossi's, but it's not going to bring him the world title, is it, Kevin?
No, and it's not going to change the history that we've just seen unfold. That's the way it is. A GP without Valentino Rossi on the podium. It's Bayliss, Caparossi and Hayden. That's interesting enough in itself.
Nicky Hayden, has it sunk in? Probably hasn't really sunk in yet. He's had so much cruel luck. The wheel of fortune has turned in favour of the 25-year-old from Owensboro in Kentucky, in the far south of North America, if you can say that. He's a lovely guy. He's made such an impression in MotoGP and on and off the track.
And the two Ducati guys embracing each other as just as they before they step on the podium there. There he is, the man of the moment, Nicky Hayden.
We've seen it at Laguna Seca, haven't we? We've seen the Kentucky jig, we've seen the hooting and roaring, but that really means nothing. This is the moment he's been waiting for. The two world champions, World Superbike and Nicky Hayden, shake hands. But it's Troy Bayliss at the top of the tree. Loris Caparossi absolutely delighted now to finish third in the world championship.
There's another first, Nick, the world superbike champion and MotoGP champion on the same podium at the last race of the year.
That's superb. Earl Hayden and the family, they put everything into motorcycle racing back home. Family, the brothers, the mum and dad, the sisters, and they've been rewarded. Loris Caparossi in second place.
I don't know if you guys mentioned it, but Troy Bayliss, is he the first World Superbike champion to win a Grand Prix?
That way round he is, isn't he? World champions have won Superbike races, but that way round. So Loris Caparossi, second place. That's enough to give him the third place in the World Championship. Troy Bayliss about to receive his just reward. What a performance by the World Superbike champion coming to MotoGP and winning the final race of the season. Congratulations to Troy Bayliss. Congratulations to Loris Caparossi. But the day and the season belong to Nicky Hayden, the 2006 MotoGP World Champion. They're everywhere. They're in the commentary box, they're in pit lane, and they're in the crowd.
Almost had a lump in my throat then, listener. It's been a while since I've heard that at the front of a GP.
We wouldn't have thought we would have been hearing that one today here at Valencia, but that's the case. Troy Bayliss, good on you. Great job. And I think he'd have to be by a long way the first World Superbike champion to win a MotoGP race. A long, long way in front of anybody else.
And to do it in such style too, that's just amazing. There you go, the fireworks.
There they go, they're in front of us. We're going to be engulfed in smoke any moment now. It's yellow smoke at the moment. Makes you think they thought perhaps someone else was going to win this race.
There's always that possibility.
Look at this display, ladies and gentlemen. Just sit back and enjoy it with Nicky Hayden. I think it's finally sinking into the Hayden family just what has happened. All those years of hard work, of scrimping and saving, of traveling first America, then the world, has paid off. They have produced a world champion.